A very good morning, Anna. Thanks for tuning into the breakfast news on Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Ashwarya Kapoor, and these are this morning's headlines. Debate and voting on no confidence motion moved by opposition parties against a central government in the Lok Sabha. BJP confident of victory, looks to win support of non-NDA parties. Congress says it will expose government's failures. Bribe givers to be punished. A new anti-corruption bill that provides imprisonment of up to 7 years passed in the Rajya Sabha. Cases to be settled in 2 years. Relief to mobile customers. Telecom regulator try revamps regulations on pesky calls and spam. Subscribers' consent mandatory for receiving telemarketing messages. Maximum penalty of 50 lakh rupees for violation under new rules. Inaugural 2+2 dialogue between India and the US are to be held on 6th of September in New Delhi. US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and Defense Secretary James Mattis to discuss the strengthening strategic, security and defense cooperation with their Indian counterparts. An indefinite nationwide strike by truckers to press for their demands, including reduction in diesel prices and toll fee. Strike call by All India Motor Transport Congress that claims over 93 lakh members. The biggest story this morning, the Lok Sabha will today take up debate and voting on the motion of no confidence in the Council of Ministers by the opposition parties. TDP's Srinivas Kesineni will move the motion. This is the first motion of no confidence since the BJP-led NDA government came to power 4 years ago. There will be no question hour and the House would have no other business barring the discussion on the motion that will take place from 11 in the morning to 6 in the evening. And after this, voting will be held. As the main mover of the motion, the TDP has been allocated 13 minutes to speak on the matter and Congress has been allocated 38 minutes. Other opposition parties such as the AIADMK, Trinamool Congress, Biju Janata Dal, Telangana Rashtra Samiti have been allocated 29 minutes, 27 minutes, 15 minutes and 9 minutes respectively. The BJP has been given 3 hours and 33 minutes. As far as the numbers are concerned, the strength of the houses are 534, excluding the speaker, and this brings down the magic mark to 268. And the BJP on its own has 273 minus the speaker. And all parties have issued whips to their MPs to be present in the house today.
Ahead of the no confidence vote in Lok Sabha, the opposition Congress has said it's more than a show of numbers, as the party will use the occasion to highlight the government's failure.
देश के लोग नो कॉन्फिडेंस मोदी सरकार में दे चुके हैं क्योंकि ना 80 लाख करोड़ काला धन वापस आया और ना 15 लाख खाते में जमा करवाया. नो कॉन्फिडेंस देश का किसान दे चुका है क्योंकि ना लागत पर 50% मुनाफा मिला ना कर्ज माफी मिली. नो कॉन्फिडेंस इस देश की गृहिणी दे चुकी है क्योंकि गैस हो या पेट्रोल डीजल उनके दाम आसमान को छू रहे हैं और बजट को आग लग गई है. नो कॉन्फिडेंस इस देश का छोटा छोटा उद्योगपति और व्यवसायी दे चुका है क्योंकि धंधा चौपट है और अर्थव्यवस्था औंधे मुंह गिरी है. जो नो कॉन्फिडेंस सदन के अंदर हो रहा है वो इस देश के 132 करोड़ लोगों की बाहर की भावना है जिसकी अभिव्यक्ति हम अंदर कर रहे हैं. संख्या का खेल एक बात हो सकती है पर इस देश का विश्वास मोदी जी खो चुके हैं.
The ruling BJP is confident that it will defeat the opposition-sponsored motion. The party's floor managers claim that the government will get the support of as many as 314 MPs. It is also likely to get the support of several other parties outside the NDA.
Modi sarkar ka badhti samarthan hai house ke andar aur house ke bahar, parliament ke andar aur parliament ke bahar. To isliye इस बार एनडीए तो एक मुस्त होकर के इस अविश्वास प्रस्ताव के खिलाफ वोट करेगी. उसके साथ एनडीए प्लस एनडीए के बाहर के कई दल भी हमें समर्थन देने वाले।
The government meanwhile is preparing to blunt the opposition offensive. All central ministries and departments have been directed to prepare a list of achievements of the government which will be highlighted during the debate in Lok Sabha. The lower house will debate and vote on the no confidence motion against the Modi government. The motion will be the first since the BJP-led NDA government came to power 4 years ago. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And Prime Minister Narendra Modi took to Twitter ahead of today's no-confidence motion. He said it is an important day in our parliamentary democracy. He added, I am sure my fellow MP colleagues will rise to the occasion and ensure a constructive, comprehensive and disruption-free debate. We owe this to the people and the makers of our constitution. India will be watching us closely. So Lok Sabha will take up a debate of no confidence motion against the Narendra Modi government brought by the TDP and the opposition parties today. Let's listen in to some of the political reactions.
Actually, Mr. Modi and BJP have lost the trust of the people, lost the hope of the people. The overall, the country is now feeling that Modi has deceived them. So all the parties, we have been talking to many parties, almost every party except BJP. So definitely, I think we have that confidence that this motion will go through.
So it gives us an opportunity to present our case forcefully in front of the nation, in front of our MPs, in front of the Prime Minister, and force the Prime Minister to respond on these issues that we raise regarding the bifurcation issues, the non-implementation of the items of the AP Reorganization Act, the non-implementation of the assurances given by then Prime Minister Manmohan Singh in Rajya Sabha. All of these things are things that are our rights. They're non-negotiable. And the implementation has been very poor and very disappointing to the people of Andhra Pradesh. And this gives us the opportunity to put our case forward.
Shiv Sena ke pakshe prukh adarni Uddhav Saab Thakari ji jis dhang se marishan karenge. Jo marishan hoga, us tarah se hum kaam karenge. Usme koi dho raayan hoi ki avashyakta nahi. पहली बात ऐसे कि वो जो अविश्वास प्रस्ताव है तो शिवसेना ने रखा है, किसी ने और ने रखा है, तो उस पर क्या भूमिका करना लेनी है, उस भूमिका को भूमिका के ऊपर हमारे पक्ष प्रमुख मार्गदर्शन करेंगे।
आज उस पर जम करके दमखम के साथ इस सरकार का विरोध करेंगे। इस सरकार में पूरा का पूरा अविश्वास है और सरकार को हम लोग सदन में गिराने का हर संभव प्रयास करेंगे। TDP ने भी लाया है, हम लोगों ने भी लाया है, RJD है, कांग्रेस पार्टी है, अन्य पार्टी है, और हम लोग जो अपनी राय रखेंगे।
अपोजिशन्स क्लेम्स ऑफ हैविंग द नंबर्स इज अ फ्रॉडुलेंट अटेम्प्ट बिकॉज दिस द वोट इन द लोकसभा क्लियरली शोज दैट द बीजेपी हैज अ मेजॉरिटी इन लोकसभा बाय इटसेल्फ एंड विथ NDA वी हैव अ साइजेबल मेजॉरिटी नियरली अ 2/3 मेजॉरिटी एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट There are many opposition parties, we are confident, will also back the government or will oppose the no confidence motion because they know this is purely a disruptive attempt and not a positive effort. So certainly the BJP will come out of this no confidence vote with flying colors.
I don't think, see, they have requisite numbers. BJP on its own, they have that number. Again, they're... Coalition partners are there, putting all the numbers together, motion will be defeated, I think. No confidence motion against the government will be defeated.
Jinka confidence, sadak ke logon ka confidence jin logon par nahi raha, वो लोग जो है वो संसद में कॉन्फिडेंस का एक औपचारिकता पूरी करना चाहते हैं और करें, उसमें कोई दिक्कत नहीं है। दूध का दूध पानी का पानी हो जाएगा, मकसद और मंशा भी साफ हो जाएगी कि विपक्ष ने पिछले जो सत्र को वॉश आउट किया इस नाम पे, तो इनके पास इनके तर्कश में कौन से तर्क थे या तुक्के थे वो पता लग जाएंगे।
And let's get more details. My colleague Kriti Mishra is now joining us from live outside the parliament right now. Kriti, now given the NDA's sheer numbers in parliament's lower house, of course, there is little doubt about a comfortable outcome for the government. But the big question will be the decision of the fence sitters, you know, this, of course, ahead of next year's general elections. So what are your sources telling you what is going to be the stand of the AIA, DMK, BJD, TRS and also Shiv Sena?
Well, Aishwarya, this motion is not going to be pernicious for the government because remember the numbers are heavily stacked in favour of the ruling dispensation. In fact, the BJP is capable of crossing the halfway mark on its own. Many NDA allies and also the non-NDA constituents are expected to corroborate the government. In fact, the fence sitters, as you pointed out, have kept their cards closer to their chest, but it is expected that at the end of the day, they are going to vote in favour of the government. Remember, the government has already launched a scathing attack, saying that the opposition may not have confidence in the NDA government, but the people have full confidence. In fact, the government is absolutely confident that after the discussion on no confidence motion and also subsequent voting, the opposition will not be left with any potent weapon to disrupt the proceedings of the House in the monsoon session. If the NDA constituents, like the Shiv Sena, they back the government, then certainly all talks would be quelled about trouble within the NDA fold and the NDA fold would emerge stronger. In fact, the government is also likely to use this opportunity to prove that the so-called unity of the opposition party is opposition parties is mendacious. Because remember, Aishwarya, more than 12 parties have given different notices for this motion. So either there's dearth of coordination among these opposition parties or they're trying to score political brownie points over each other. And also, Aishwarya, very importantly, the BJP has a stupendous orator in Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So he is expected to make a speech and when millions would be listening to him, so the BJP expects him to highlight the achievements of the government. And the last such no confidence motion was moved in 2003 when Vajpayee government emerged victorious over his political detractors. So the BJP is expecting a replica of the same as the day progresses. Aishwarya?
And Kriti, speaking about the opposition, of course, we understand that Mallikarjun Kharge has reached out to the SP, TMC, also left parties for coordination. And for today's debate, we understand that, you know, besides Rahul Gandhi, who all are others who are likely to participate in the debate today?
Well, most of the parties are expected to participate in the debate today. So the opposition is trying to stitch a strategy on the floor of the House that has to be exhibited today. So let's talk about the prime mover of this motion, which is the TDP. Now, ahead of the elections, the TDP is trying to score political points because remember, as far as the issue of special category status to Andhra Pradesh is concerned, the government has clarified that after the recommendations, after the acceptance and after the implementation of recommendations of 14th Finance Commission, the concept of special category status ceased to exist and Andhra Pradesh, the government has already clarified, would be given an amount equivalent to the special status in form of a special packet. So that is certainly a very important point for the TDP and it is trying to reap political dividends out of it. Let's talk about the Congress. Remember earlier, the Congress said that the numbers are in favour of the opposition. That attracted a sharp retort from the government. So yesterday, the Congress has maintained that it is just not about the numbers. It is about the message. It is to show mirror to the government. And remember, the government has already taken jibes on the Congress president, saying that in the last session, he had mentioned that if he's allowed to speak for 15 minutes in parliament, an earthquake would occur. So certainly the BJP would be looking out for it.
Absolutely. So BJP has the numbers really to coast through this no confidence motion. But of course, ahead of the general elections in 2019, the party is looking to delineate a political message. And so is the opposition in that case. Thank you so much, Kriti, for all those updates there. You keep tracking all those developments in Parliament. We'll keep coming back to you. And earlier, the Rajya Sabha passed the Prevention of Corruption Amendment Bill 2013 on Thursday and passed by a voice vote. The bill makes giving bribes to a public servant an offence. The bill amends the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988 to modify definitions and penalties for offences related to taking a bribe, being a habitual offender and also abetting an offence. It also redefines criminal misconduct to only cover misappropriation of property and possession of disproportionate assets. Minister of State for Personal, Public Grievances and Pensions, Jitendra Singh said that the bill has incorporated recommendations made by the Standing Committee, the Law Commission and the Select Committee as well. He also responded to the concerns raised by the opposition. Let's take a listen.
I agree with you, in the amendments it has said pecuniary and other gratifications. Now, pecuniary of course related to money. Other means that if it is not in the form of money, if it is by other means also it should come in the purview. We could not have defined it because then you cannot keep on counting all the items which would come in that. But that is left to the wisdom of the investigating authorities and the select committee comprised of members from all the political parties.
लोकपाल तो अपने बनाया नहीं, हमारे समय बड़ा आंदोलन किया, सब लोग आंदोलन में, प्रचंड आंदोलन हुआ, लोकपाल बनाओ, लोकपाल का कानून बनाओ, अब लोकपाल कहाँ है? हम तो यहाँ आ गए, पर लोकपाल कहाँ गया? ये सवाल है आज, और आगे के लिए जो भ्रष्टाचार करेंगे, आप लोकपाल बनाएंगे, फिर वो लोकपाल अनुमति देगा। मेरे आपसे एक आग्रह है, इसमें संशोधन में संशोधन लाएं, लोकपाल की जगह ये अधिकार सरकार का होना चाहिए।
कि भाई जो एनएन वोहरा साहब की जो एक गृह मंत्रालय में एक रिपोर्ट रखी गई थी हिंदुस्तान के अंदर तमाम संगठित अपराधों पर एक रिपोर्ट बड़ी महत्वपूर्ण रिपोर्ट थी आज तक सदन ने चर्चा नहीं किया उसके ऊपर तो आखिर हम भ्रष्टाचार निवारण करना किस लिए चाहते हैं
एंटायर गवर्नमेंट एंटायर अपोजिशन एंटायर पार्लियामेंट एंटायर जुडिशियल सिस्टम इज लुकिंग हेल्पलेस दिस सिचुएशन इज नॉट एट ऑल वारंटेड And therefore, those who have taken money from the bank and the willful defaulters, in spite of their ability to repay, they are not repaying. They must be covered under the Prevention of Corruption Act.
And the Lok Sabha passed the Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill on a Thursday and passed by a voice vote. The bill gives authorities a power to attach and confiscate the properties and assets of economic offenders who flee the country. The bill will replace the ordinance promulgated in April this year. Finance Minister Piyush Goyal said the bill gave power to the agencies to seize properties which are not only in the name of offender but also the ones that are Benami. He said it is the first time since independence that such a measure has been taken against fugitive economic offenders. And during the almost two-hour-long debate on the bill, the opposition raised several concerns regarding the provisions of the bill. BSP member N.K. Premachandran said that the bill should be sent to a standing committee for evaluation. Congress MP Shashi Tharoor demanded a few changes in the bill's provisions.
ये ordinance लाना इसलिए जरूरी था कि ये कार्रवाई रुके ना, ये कार्रवाई थमे ना, और ये मैसेज जाए कि भारत सरकार अब एकदम सीरियसली नई सरकार आई है, काले धन के ऊपर प्रहार हो रहा है, और एक सीरीज ऑफ मेजर्स में ये एक मेजर लिया गया कि ऐसे जो भी केसेस हैं जहां ऑफेंडर्स भारत की सीमाओं को छोड़ के चले जाते हैं इनको इनकी संपत्ति को जब्त करने का कानून लाया जाए इसलिए इसको ऑर्डिनेंस के रूप में हमने पास किया तो अगर कोई आज भगोड़ा है और बाहर रहता है तो ही इज ऑलरेडी अ फ्यूजिटिव ही इज रनिंग अवे फ्रॉम इंडियन लॉ और वो भी सेक्शन 3 के द्वारा इस कानून में कवर हो जाते हैं
Let's get to some other news now. The centre has learned to have begun preliminary discussions on the possibility of bringing a new law to curb mob lynching. One of the options being mulled is to amend the Indian Penal Code to define mob lynching as a penal offence. And another option being considered is to draft a model law that states can adopt to prevent the incidents of mob lynching. The government may also further strengthen the framework relating to social media to ensure that rumours which may lead to such incidents are checked. Meanwhile, India has expressed dissatisfaction over measures listed by WhatsApp for checking of fake news that have in several cases led to mob violence. Now, New Delhi has said that the company cannot escape its responsibility for such rampant abuse and needs to find originators of provocative messages. In the second notice to the US-based messaging service in 3 weeks, the government warned that in the absence of adequate checks, it will treat the messaging platform as a better of rumor propagation and legal consequences will follow. On the other hand, according to media reports, Facebook has said that it will start removing fake news and misinformation from its platform after criticism that the flow of rumors had sparked violence and led to physical harm to people in countries around the world. And the Prime Minister Narendra Modi led a Lokpal selection committee held its meeting to set up a search panel for recommending names for the appointment of the anti-graft ombudsman and its members. Now, matters relating to the constitution of the search committee was discussed in the meet. The meeting was attended by Chief Justice of India Deepak Mishra, Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan and former Attorney General and Senior Advocate Mukul Rohtagi. However, Congress's Mallikarjun Kharge, who is a special invitee to the selection committee, did not attend the meeting. In a letter to the Prime Minister, Kharge said that he will not attend the meeting till the time the leader of the single largest opposition party is made a full-fledged member of the panel. On to the other top story of the day, the inaugural 2+2 dialogue between India and the US will be held on 6th of September in New Delhi. This was announced by US State Department after the country had postponed the dialogue last month due to what it called were unavoidable reasons. The Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and Defense Secretary James Mattis would travel to India for the dialogue. In a statement, a US State Department spokesperson Heather Nauert said that Pompeo and Mattis look forward to meeting with their Indian counterparts, that is External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj and Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, to discuss the strengthening of strategic security and defense cooperation as the US and India jointly address challenges in the Indo-Pacific region and beyond. During the dialogue, India is looking to get a waiver from the CATSA Act, which will hit Indian military imports from Russia and also the import of crude oil from Iran. The dialogue was announced last year during Prime Minister Narendra Modi's meeting with President Donald Trump at the White House. And telecom regulator TRAI has revamped the regulation on pesky calls and spam as it spelled out new rules mandating subscribers' consent for receiving telemarketing messages. The regulator also asked the telecom operators to ensure that commercial communication takes place only through registered senders. The registration of a subscriber consent will put an end to major abuse of the current regulations. TRAI said that every access provider should establish custom preference registration facility and make necessary arrangements to facilitate customers by providing ways and means to record the consent or its revocation related to the commercial communication. And millions of truckers from across the country are likely to go on an indefinite strike from today, demanding a slew of actions from the government, including lowering of diesel prices and also toll fee. Now, truckers are claiming over 93 lakh members have announced the strike. They are demanding reduction in central and state taxes and by getting diesel under the GST so that price of the deregulated commodity can be reduced. Bal Malkit Singh, the chairman of the All India Motor Transport Congress Core Committee, said that the union held a meeting with the Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari, but that was inconclusive. And the Supreme Court has questioned the rationale behind banning the entry of women in the 10 to 50 age group into the famous Sabarimala temple in Kerala. The apex court argued that menstruation may begin before the age of 10 and menopause may hit women much earlier. The Travancore Devaswam board argued that menstruating women are not allowed inside the temple because of the nature of the deity. The board insisted that women aged between 10 to 50 years cannot observe purity and penance for a period of 41 days. The argument came a day after the Supreme Court said that women, just like men, have the right to enter the Sabarimala temple and pray. The Kerala government, meanwhile, told the court that it supported the entry of women of all age groups into the shrine. The arguments in the matter remained inconclusive and they would resume on 24th of July. Let's get you some weather news now. In Kerala and in Gujarat, heavy rains continue to wreak havoc and the toll in rain-related incidents in Kerala has now climbed to 39 as 11 more deaths have been reported in the last 24 hours in the state. Low-lying regions in Kottayam and Alappuzha district continue to be flooded. The Kerala government sought centre support and urged it to send a delegation to take stock of the situation. And the Met Department has warned that the downpour is likely to continue till Sunday. Meanwhile, over 700 people have been rescued from flooded spots in the last 1 week as incessant rains are lashing south of Gujarat and Saurashtra region, affecting 25 villages there. As many as 33 people have lost their lives in rain-related incidents in the state since the onset of monsoon. And Gujarat Chief Minister Vijay Rupani has said that electricity supply has been restored in all affected villages, while the work to repair roads damaged by rain have been started. He also announced the formation of teams to assess the loss of property and damage to crops. Now let's get a wrap of all the international news. Here is the world wrap. U.S. President Donald Trump has invited Russian leader Vladimir Putin to visit the U.S. in the autumn. Donald Trump's press secretary Sarah Sanders tweeted that discussions for the visit were already underway. Earlier, Donald Trump rejected a proposal by Putin that Russia be allowed to question U.S. citizens. The two leaders held a summit in Finland on Monday, but few details of what they discussed have emerged. There has been no word from Russia about a second Trump-Putin meeting. Russia and China on Thursday put a six-month hold, a request from the U.S. to the United Nations Security Council to hold all deliveries of refined oil products to North Korea. The U.S. asked a UN's sanctions committee last week to ban further fuel shipments, accusing Pyongyang of using illegal imports to exceed a cap on permissible deliveries. A cutoff of oil and fuel would have to be enforced primarily by China, which supplies most of North Korea's energy needs, but also by Russia, which delivers some oil to Pyongyang. However, Russia and China told the council that they needed more time to consider the US's request. And Israel passed a controversial law on Thursday declaring that only Jews have the right of self-determination in the country. The law stirred anger from the members of Arab minority who said that it was racist, and it also drew an expression of concern from the EU. The bill passed with a 62-55 backing after months of political arguments, and some Arab lawmakers shouted and ripped up their papers after the vote. Largely symbolic, the law was enacted just after the 70th anniversary of the birth of the State of Israel. On to some other news. The most respected Hindi poet Gopal Das Neeraj passed away on Thursday evening at the AIIMS Trauma Centre in New Delhi at the age of 93. Gopal Das Neeraj had suffered a head injury following a fall at his house in Agra, and he was undergoing treatment. The poet had written songs for Bollywood films as well. Gopal Das Neeraj was awarded Padma Shri in 1991 and Padma Bhushan in 2007. The President and Prime Minister took to social media to express their condolences after the news of his death broke. They offered condolences via Twitter. Prime Minister Narendra Modi called his work as unforgettable gems. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Breakfast News. Thanks for watching. Have a great day ahead.